Hello, I'm Michał Rećko, and in today's video I'm gonna show you how I learned how to use Raspberry Pi and then made my first game using it. So firstly, what's Raspberry Pi? Well, it's basically a small computer that can be used for robotics and other cool stuff. There's also Minecraft Raspberry Pi edition, so there's no reason not to buy it. Going back to the story, I recently challenged myself to learn how to use Raspberry Pi together with all sorts of components that you can connect to it. Luckily, the kit with components I own has a tutorial I could download from the internet. Let's check how long it is. Okay, so 30, 60? Oh god, that's long. That's very long. How long? 318 pages. Okay, so it is very long, but I have a lot of spare time, so it should take me no time to complete it. So the first task was to make a blinking LED. All I had to do was just build the circuit as code was provided with tutorial. But it's always a good idea to examine the code for obvious reason, as I have to learn how to program on Raspberry. There's been two types of code provided, the one written in C and the one written in Python. Of course I went with the one written in C, as I'm already familiar with C# and my bet was that they are very similar languages. But are they? Well, C is kind of like free child of C#. It looks similar but lacks half of the functions. This doesn't mean it's bad, but when I started making a project of my own, I had to come up with different ways of dealing with things. Other major difference between C and C# is that C is procedural-oriented programming, and C# is object-oriented programming. What's the difference? I'm not exactly sure. Now, on the screen I'm going to show compression of both types of languages I found online. It is made up of multiple magic sentences like in object-oriented programming data is more important than function, whatever that means. Anyway, I will quite quickly learn that C is a very fun language, and it actually has a function that I would love to see in C#, and it's a delay. Just look at it, it's amazing. You just type in delay and then write how many milliseconds you want it to wait. I know there's coroutines in C# and I'm using them, but still just remember that this is one line of code and it looks much better than all this time.delta time nonsense. So I continued doing the tutorial that slowly went through all the components and taught me how to do things like
blinking LED, LED turned on with a button, LED with flowing water sequence, breathing LED, soft light LED, LED with customizable RGB, multicolored LED, and that's about it.
Outside of LED side of spectrum, I've also learned how to use buzzer. And that's about it. So all of this was completed within a day, and a big chunk of tutorial was completed. But there was a still long way to go. Here I had two choices. Make a project from scratch with things I've already learned, or continue doing the tutorial. Knowing it was Tuesday and I had a plan to make videos every Wednesday, I decided to make something from scratch, so I have a content for next video. But if you check the gap between this video and next video, you will see that this actually didn't work out. Anyways, my idea was to make Simon. If you don't know what Simon is, it's a small game where buttons light up in random order, after which player must reproduce that order by pressing the buttons. By the way, did you know that Simon was made by Ralph Beer, the same guy behind Magnavox Odyssey, the very first console ever made, the one that runs original table tennis from 1972. This guy is a legend. Can you imagine how boring the world would be without him? So I've planned out how I want to approach making this game. Firstly, I decided to use RGB LED to show the colors. That's because one LED takes up significantly less space on breadboard compared to four LEDs. And it also doesn't use that many GPIO pins. Firstly, I wrote a program that lights up LED in random colors. This came with its challenges, as each color required different resistors. And I've soon found out that I don't have two of those resistors. So I really had to play with resistors, I had to achieve something. At the end I've managed to create 3 colors, not 4 like in original Simon game unfortunately. Those colors are yellow, blue and red, which looks like pink. Next thing I had to do was program the buttons. This part didn't cause any problems at all. You might ask how the algorithm for this game works. Well, let me explain. Firstly, RGB LED displays random colors. Each color is given a number from 1 to 3, as there are 3 colors. Those numbers are saved as an integers that are placed in an array. The same thing happens when you press one of the buttons. Each button has an assigned number and once you press it, this number is placed into an array. At the end, the arrays are compared and if they're the same, you win and if they're not, you lose. Now I had some problems making it, but that's mostly because I was still learning the C language. With that being completed, the game was pretty much done. It was doing exactly what I wanted it to do, but there still wasn't any output that would tell player if he won or lost. That's where I plugged in the buzzer into Raspberry Pi. The idea was that when button press is registered, you will get sound notification that is short beep. If you lose, buzzer will beep twice, and if you win, buzzer will beep three times. Honestly, that was the easiest thing to set up, no problems there, and it took me only like 5 seconds to complete. And finally, after a couple of days, Simon was completed. So, in conclusion, what do I think of Raspberry Pi? I think it's great. I really enjoyed playing around with making the circuits and programming them. I will certainly make more projects using it and then I will show them to you. If you enjoy programming or robotics, you should buy it, as it's really fun. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like it and share it with your friends. It helps the channel grow. And if you want to see more content like this, make sure to subscribe. I try to post as often as I can. And for now, bye bye!